These are the old-style Windermere fixtures. The R12 type glass on them and short standards. Close-up of your R12. These are a short concrete decorative standard. This is your 175-watt style view luminaire. These are on a 19-foot aluminum pole. This is a 1,000-watt mercury vapor. These particular ones are on Aurora Avenue North. On a 28-foot steel transformer base pole. This is the flat lens McGraw-Edison 250-watt high-pressure sodium on the concrete standards with a steel arm and Ballard.
Thank you. Yeah. Come in tight on that base. The next one.
Yeah.
Where is it? There it is. Good.
Contact 315 and tell them I'm at the corner of 100 Northeast 195th and 47th Northeast. Could they send someone over here, Drew?
What color top has that got on it? Thank you. picture of a nice cluttered pole here.
Don't need the pole or anything, do you?
No. There's nobody behind me now either. I guess it's another one.
344. Dispatcher 407.
407.
Yeah, earlier I
the post too? Do you want the pole too?
Yeah.
Get out there and stop traffic for a minute.
I can back up the deal and we can get it. Are we a little close?
Just there, July 76. 49 south.
The street lighting division has put together a tape depicting the replacement of certain poles in the central business district of Seattle. These are poles that have been removed and replaced, and we're showing the removing of the copper skin from the steel shaft. When the skin is removed, the outer skin is removed, it will be noted that there's a large amount of rust and shale on the steel shaft inside, particularly around any holes that have been bored in this pole in the past. Here we're chipping away some of the rust and shale. We're not actually cutting this, just chipping it loose. The large amount of rust in here is the reason that these poles were deemed structurally unsound. You'll notice how thin the steel is at this point, and it takes very little encouragement with the hammer to break it. We're at the corner of 4th and Cherry. The crew is setting out cones in preparation for their work. Mr. Sparling is preparing to remove the base of the standard. It will first be raised up the pole with the use of a coffin hoist. Excess grout has been dumped in this base. The hardware off the top of the pole must be removed. The grout that's been dumped into the base must be chipped out so that the structural iron worker can cut the nuts off of the bolts with the acetylene torch. The bolts are so old and rusty that it's almost impossible to remove them with a wrench. Signals being given to the crane operator and the pole jumps off the base. The bronze skirt and collar will be removed from this standard after it's laid down and reinstalled on the new shaft. This is the new shaft being prepared to be put in place. Now this new shaft is just a galvanized steel shaft. It does not have the copper skin on it. The crew here consists of two journeymen and a helper, and the use of the structural iron worker for about half an hour. Here's the bronze skirt being raised over the top of the new standard and will be lowered in place. And the collar to be set down on top of it. The base is set on wooden blocks until the traffic signal people can get their traffic signals back onto the new standard. Now completing the job, Mr. Bevins is installing the new luminaire.